Good morning, Rams.
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 Good morning, Rams. And welcome to the last Ram Report morning show of the 2019 and 2020 school year. I'm Cecilia Tabor.
And I'm Brandon Sagbo. We have enjoyed giving you the best news that High Sound has to offer.
This year is coming to an end, and not in the way that we hope.
Yes, there have been many ups and downs, but we at the Ram Report want to give you some of our best moments.
Of course, this couldn't have been done with all of you supportive teachers and students.
And especially without the support and guidance of our broadcasting teacher, Mr. Coons.
You're totally right. He completely transformed the Ram Report for us this year, and we are really thankful for that.
Here's a message from Mr. Coons.
Thank you, Brandon and Cecilia, for those kind words. I want to thank all of the students in my honors broadcasting class for making this an exciting year. We had a lot of new experiences this year, first putting on live stream shows and then transitioning to this remote learning broadcast. I hope you had as much fun learning in this class as I had fun teaching it. I also learned a thing or two myself from you in this class, and that was the power of a television show like the Ram Report Morning Show to bring us all together. You have to realize when we're all separated in this social distancing environment with the school building closed and we're not sharing a lot of the same common experiences that we used to share, that a show like the Ram Report Morning Show, something that comes on every Friday that we can all watch together, has a way of building a sense of community. That doesn't happen by itself. It takes a lot of hard work, and that's the work that you did consistently every week with lots of positive energy, and I can't thank you enough for that. To my seniors, I wish you the very, very best going forward in your futures. And I want to send a special shout out to some of my go-to guys that have made the Ram Report so special. Spencer and Justin, thanks for all the laughs. John Shell and Dylan Pazlesny, my go-to hard news guys, thank you. And to the students that were my anchors in more ways than one, Tyler Shamper, Brandon Sagbo, and Cecilia Tabor. I couldn't have done it without you guys. Thank you so much. Best of luck to you in the future. And with that, back to you, Brandon and Cecilia.
We are also very thankful for the administration and Mr. Vincent for being so present in our program this school year.
We loved having other teachers and administration in all of our videos. Here's Mr. Vincent.
Good morning, Rams. Today is the final edition of our live Ram Report. As I reflect back on this year, a couple things cross my mind. One, it's amazing that we have gone live now with the Ram Report on a regular basis. Our Ram Report team, made up of our students and our staff, really truly have taken the Ram Report to another level. The second thing I just want to reflect back on is what the Ram Report has meant to all of us while we've been out on remote learning during this pandemic. Many of us have looked forward to the Friday edition to get caught up with the news around town. And even though many of us already knew what those news events were, it was amazing to see our students produce it. I can't thank the Ram Report team enough. You've gone above and beyond, and what you've really done is what we strive for every day here at Hightstown High School. You made learning real. You connected to the realities of our world and took what you learned in the classroom and applied it to real life. I wish the Ram reporters who are leaving us nothing but great success. And remember, always be safe, Rams.
Now, without further ado, here is the Ram Report in review.
We'll be highlighting some of our most favorite moments, both in school and out of school.
We'll start off the show with our best co-anchor moments.
I might be biased, but I think we're the best duo.
You know, I do too. Let's take a look.
You know, Cecilia, all this talk about surprises just reminded me that I have a surprise for you.
And what's that?
Well, I still do need to repay you for that FBLA rose you got me on Valentine's Day.
Oh, and how are you going to do that?
Well, seeing it's decision day and all, I thought you could use some school spirit.
Wow, Brandon. Thank you. It's a Westchester University t-shirt. That's where I'm going. That's my school.
Good morning, Rams, and welcome back to the Ram Report Morning Show. I'm Spencer Cohen, bringing you the best news Hightstown has to offer.
Whoa. Okay, this is not the Ram Report Morning Show. This is Have You Heard.
You're right. It's Have You Heard. Welcome back. My name is Spencer Cohen.
And I'm Justin Sabigal. And this is the Have You Heard Winter Showcase Edition.
Justin,
And good job. I mean, I sure hope I'll be getting a flower gram today.
You don't have to hope anymore, Brandon.
Oh, well, that's a first. Thank you so much, Cecilia Tabor.
Good morning, Rams, and happy Halloween. Welcome back to the second edition of Have You Heard?
This has been another edition of the Ram Report Morning Show. I'm Tyler Shamper.
And I'm Brandon Sagbo, and have a ram-tastic day.
We definitely killed it.
Definitely did. And while we may be good at co-anchoring, there's many students at this school that are great at music.
Totally. We've had so many great musical performances on our channel this year.
Now let's take a look back at some of our favorites. If you couldn't keep a straight face during that, then this next segment will have you rolling. Here's the funniest moments.
In order to get a taste of the Hightstown community, we head to downtown Hightstown in our very own ketchup and mustard costumes. Look how foolish we look. Anyway, we shortly arrive to one of the houses to talk with the owner.
What is this? Dude, are you hiding money under the board this whole time?
No, I'm not. It's 200.
Can you see I'm counting it right now?
No, I need my 200.
I'm counting it right now! Just let me count it! 200. Are you kidding me? Get out of here! I'm done with this game!
Some juniors were lucky enough to receive their licenses before the closure and have been able to take full advantage of the perks during quarantine.
And as they say in music, beauty is in the ear of the listener.
Now the real question is, will I be receiving a flower gram? I hope so.
Welcome to a special edition of the Ram Report, where today we will be reviewing the 2020 Hightstown High School Talent Show. I'm your host, Cecilia Tabor, and today I have a special guest. Mr. Coombs, why do you look so sad? There's a moment in your bones when the fire
takes over. Blood is running, heart is
Okay. You may have thought I was the one to pull off all of these trick shots like Dude Perfect. I thought that too. Here's what actually happened. Miss after miss. Until finally.
Next up, we have one of our most frequent guests at the show.
Mr. Vincent visited us on multiple occasions. Here are some of the highlights.
I wish you and your family a happy and healthy and relaxing Thanksgiving. And as always, be safe, Rams. Which allowed me some time to reflect on what does winter break really mean. As I was walking around the building the other day, I had the opportunity to stop into a class. And I happened to stop into this class, and the conversation was winter solstice, which I quickly Googled winter solstice, the date, because I knew it was quickly fast upon us. Tomorrow is winter solstice for all of winter solstice. And the winter solstice means winter solstice. And what a winter solstice means to me. And happy winter break. And as always, please be safe, Rams.
This has been a special holiday message from Mr. Vinson.
Despite this pandemic, that our Hightstown teachers are doing everything they can for our graduation to be the best it could be.
I think it's an important idea. If you have a moment, can you please reach out to a teacher? I know they've been checking in on you. It'd be great if you check in on one of your teachers. Again, next week, Teacher Appreciation Week, simply drop them a line and see how they're doing. It'd be great. As always, Rams, make sure you stay safe. If you need anything, please do not hesitate to reach out to your assistant principal, your counselor, or myself.
It's really awesome that our principal showed us this much support this school year.
Our next segment is one of my favorites, the Ram Report review shows.
We reviewed many things on the Ram Report, from TV shows, board games, and talent shows.
So let's review our review shows.
Do you guys remember Flappy Bird? Well, during this time of social distancing, I've been getting back into it. Honestly, once I picked it up, I couldn't put it back down.
This is ridiculous!
I need to social distance myself from Flappy Bird. I give this game a 1 out of 5 Rams.
If you love board games, The Settlers of Catan is the game for you. This fun, family-friendly game involves lots of strategy as each player tries to expand their roads, settlements, and cities across the island. Each player rolls the die and collects resources from the various spaces on the island. They then are able to build more and advance their settlement across the island. However, beware, because truces can easily be made and sabotage is common, even in what you believe to be your most trusted family members. This is a fun, family-friendly game that is a great game to play with your family when you're stuck inside in quarantine and will be sure to keep you entertained for hours.
Harry Potter and the Cursed Child is actually a play. It was published in script format before its Broadway debut. This may seem like a good read for Harry Potter fans, but J.K. Rowling seems to have forgotten the plot of her own novels. There are major discrepancies between this book and the original series.
Looking for a new show to watch on Netflix? Well, Magic and Mystery Lovers, you found your match. Netflix's original series, Lock and Key, is based off a popular comic series that follows a family that moves into an old house after the loss of their father. The house is filled with magical keys, which results in the show's suspense and curiosity.
Absolutely. Lara Capel, you win 3 tiers and are the first ever champion of the Ram Report Sad Song Contest. This complimentary box of Kleenex is yours. In the eyes of this observer, their show, while well choreographed and nicely executed, was, well, more like a cheer routine than a lip sync. Actually, correction on that no male representation thing. A couple of guys did finally show up with this sign. A moment that made little sense and frankly distracted from the performance. The first class that I can think of that danced the hora during a lip sync. What did they think this was? A bar mitzvah? They even brought along a life raft, but it wasn't enough to save their sinking performance, and the juniors went down to 3rd place.
For all that judging that Mr. Koontz does, I wonder if he would win a lip sync competition.
You're right. He never shows anyone any mercy in his review shows, especially the class of 2021.
Now let's jump straight into our next segment, our favorite stories.
Saturday, the New Jersey Wrestling Match of the Year lived up to the hype as the Hightstown wrestling team was able to pull off the wild underdog victory versus the Hopewell Bulldogs, snapping the Bulldogs' 50-match win streak in the CBC. The match began with some major trouble for the Rams as Hopewell won the coin toss, allowing them to switch their heavyweight wrestler off dominant Brian Bonilla onto heavyweight sophomore Brennan Hansen. Despite being down 3 points in what Hopewell believed to be a guaranteed win, Hansen stunned both Hopewell and the home crowd by pinning his opponent, giving Hightstown 6 points as the crowd erupted.
Health. This year saw the return of past activities such as journaling, stress-relieving play, and yoga, as well as the addition of a new fan favorite, therapy dogs. Students were able to attend Wellness Day with their physical education class and were allowed to select three activities to participate during the 55-minute period. Headstone and East Windsor police barricaded the rest of Main Street to guide the march back towards the school. However, the protest wasn't going anywhere unless they knew the police were on their side. All the protesters took a knee and asked for the officers to do the same in show of support.
Ridiculous! I'm no different from him! I'm no different from her! I'm no different from her! We love you! This is not hate! This is all love! I just want you to love me back! That's all I want!
Armed with signs, the teachers fanned out to the neighborhoods in Hightstown, East Windsor, and Roosevelt. With technology allowing the location of every single senior to be pinpointed through Google Maps, it was a simple matter for most teachers to consult their phones and plant their signs.
Yay, seniors! Woohoo!
But there are some teachers who still insist on doing things the hard way. Beautiful weather and no traffic on the roads, the teachers were soon done, and the seniors were very surprised.
It was really nice to review some of our favorite stories of this year.
And it was really nice to go and get the scoop on things that are going on in our community.
Of course, these stories wouldn't be the same without some of our student interviews.
Now here are some of our favorites.
Anna, you joined many other girls who have dyed your hair a different color during this quarantine. Why did you do it?
So I usually go to the hair salon to get my hair dyed, but obviously since they're closed, I had to do it myself. It was between that or cutting my own hair, which I wasn't about to do.
And I know this is going to blow up and get more views than the teacher band. Come on. This has to.
The leading favorite for the dunk contest, obviously me. There are some people that... You know, there are rumors going around on social media, you know, some different people. It's clearly been me. It's been me the whole time.
The way that me and my friends came up with the design on our storefront was being that our business was Morgan's Island Grill, and the theme of all the paintings was basically holiday theme, we thought that we could put Santa on a beach in a chair sunbathing in shorts. And we thought that would be a perfect fit for Morgan's Island Grill.
Really the next generation for real. I'm like, the students of today, we're the adults of tomorrow. So as long as all of us know what's up, everyone here today knows what's up. And as long as we maintain that mindset throughout our life, in the future, we'll be good. That's it.
What I wanted to accomplish here today was just equality. I just want peace, love, and understanding from everyone. And that's all we can ask for and all it takes. This crowd today was beautiful, man. That's art. This is Hightstown right here.
As this is our last show, we figured that we'd take it back all the way to the start.
We have grown so much from the beginning of the year, so we want to take a look at some of our RAM reports first and last and compare them. Here they are.
Good morning, and welcome to the RAM Report Morning Show. I'm your host, Justin Sabigal, and we read the news so you don't have to read your email.
Thank you, and have a RAM-tastic day.
And that was our new opening graphic with the musical composition done by Hightstown's very own, Very Thompson.
We got the chance to talk to co-founder Nick Netta, and we asked him what the Positivity Club is and why students should join.
The Positivity Club is a club where underclassmen and seniors and juniors can go to have a relief or relaxation from home life, school.
Now we go to Cecilia Tabor for the RAM Report's first ever weather report. Cecilia?
Thank you, John. The weather today is expected to be mostly cloudy with a chance of afternoon fog. There is currently a high of 49 degrees in Hightstown. It is 30 degrees and it feels like 25 degrees with the wind chill.
Good morning and welcome back to the RAM Report Morning Show. I'm Emily Dougherty.
And I'm Tyler Shamper, bringing you the best news Hightstown has to offer.
During this national emergency caused by the coronavirus outbreak, we hope to continue to bring you the RAM Report Morning Show every Friday to keep you up to date on the latest Hightstown High School news, as well as preserve a sense of community that we all share as Hightstown Rams. We're all in this together, and we'll make it through it together. Ram strong.
Welcome to this special edition of the RAM Report. I'm Cecilia Tabor.
And I'm Brandon Sagbo, and welcome to the National College and Post-Secondary Decision Day. Here's Cecilia Tabor with the weather.
Thank you, Brandon. It's Cecilia Tabor back to give you the weather forecast for our Memorial Day break.
Taking a look at the radar, we can see that there will be a low-pressure system moving into our area, bringing us some precipitation around Friday or Saturday.
Wow, that was just amazing. Be sure to check out the very last RAM report of the school year coming up next week. Until then, I'm your host, Tyler Shamper, and have a RAM-tastic day.
I really can't believe that this is our last episode.
Brandon, I don't think we could close this off without our caps and gowns.
You know, Cecilia, you're right. To Hightstown, it has truly been an honor for us to present the news to you week in, week out.
To the class of 2020, we miss you all, and we really wish that we could have celebrated all of our accomplishments and milestones together.
And to the rest of the classes, we wish you the best of luck, and we know you're going to continue putting Hightstown on the map.
And now, for the last time, we have to say goodbye.
It is truly sad, but we can't sign out without the rest of our classmates.
Thank you, and have a ram-tastic day.
Thank you, and have a ram-tastic day.
Thank you.
And have a ram-tastic day.
Thank you, and have a ram-tastic day.
Thank you.
And have a ram-tastic day.
Thank you, and have a ram-tastic day.
And for the last time, I'm Cecilia Tabor.
I'm Brandon Sagbo.
And I'm Tyler Shamper. For the Ram Report.
And have a ram-tastic day.